Hi, I'm Shang Song, and I'm a third-year graduate student in the bioengineering joint program between UC Berkeley and UCSF. Currently, I'm working in Professor Shu Roy's lab, and I'm working on the bioartificial pancreas project. So I was born and raised in China, but then I moved to Guam when I was in high school, and afterwards I came to the States, and I studied at Brown University on the East Coast. At first, I was really into organic chemistry, so making things. Then later on, like, I took more engineering classes, particularly like some teacher engineering classes. Then I found, oh, how about you combine like living like organism with like a type of material, and you can see how they interact. The problem that I'm studying right now is the type 1 diabetes, because the Medicare cost like is very high. It's $16 billion in direct costs, and also there's 4 million people in the U.S. who have been diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. The patients, they cannot produce insulin themselves. That's critical. If you don't produce insulin, you pretty much die. Like, you don't give yourself like regular doses. And the challenge is that for patients like that, it's really hard to control their glucose level. For my artificial pancreas project, it's basically like keeping cells alive in some kind of biomaterials. The idea is that when you transplant like just the cells into the body, those cells are not going to stay, the naked cells, they don't stay very long. They're just going to be attacked by your immune cells, immune component like T cells or the factors like cytokine that's secreted by the T cells. So those cells, whatever you get into the implanted body, the cells, will be dead like instantly, unless you have immune suppressant to suppress your host immune response to keep those alive. And then, people talk about like transplant and other like devices. First of all, we know about transplant. We don't have enough organs, like donate organs for transplant in the first place. That's the situation right now. So I have to find other alternatives to solve this problem. Once, if they get transplant, they have to be on immunosuppressant. That's a lifelong commitment. And you can come up with many other side effects as well. Your immune system will be pretty much damaged. If there's a bacterial infection or any sort like that, your body cannot really hone like an immune response to it. So all of those problems led us to think about how can we make things easier, like why people have to go through all this things. Don't be hesitant. I have to stress this many, many times, especially for high school kids or other, people who want to get involved with research. Don't be hesitant and don't feel shy about it. You have to, move the first step out by contacting either the PI or the lab manager or the graduate students in the lab, expressing your interest and about why you want to, join this project or work in their labs. Especially at UCSF, we're very interested in getting young people, like younger generation, get involved in our projects. That's the future of our society, and we want to get more people educated about what we do, and teach the younger generation as well.